So did you know that you can have a mole growing on the back of your eyeball? Many eye doctors refer to this as having a freckle on the retina, but its technical name is called a choroidal nevus. Either way, detecting and monitoring these are super important because just like a mole on your skin, it has the potential to grow. And in the back of the eye, we call that a choroidal melanoma, which is a very serious and potentially deadly form of eye cancer. So in this video, we're going to review what a choroidal nevus is and what tests your doctor may order to help them monitor for potential choroidal melanoma. All of this so that you know more about what's going on with your eyes and your eye health. Let's take a look. Hey, what's up? This is Dr. Alan here from the Dr. Eye Health Show. Now, if you've ever had a doctor tell you that you have a freckle growing on the back of your eye, there's a couple different things they could be referring to, but most often it's what is called a choroidal nevus. And a choroidal nevus is more or less just a mole that can grow on the back side of the eye behind the retina on a structure called the choroid. And actually, this hits pretty close to home for me because I myself have one of these in the back of my eye. Now, these moles on the back of the eye, or choroidal nevi, are usually found in about 7 to 10% of the population. You are usually born with them, and then they are believed to slowly grow during your prepubescent years. But then, once you become an adult, it's rare for them to grow. So if your doctor ever detects one of these and finds that they could be slowly growing, that can be very, very concerning. Specifically, your doctor is going to be concerned about that growing and becoming a choroidal melanoma. A very serious type of eye cancer, and just like with any cancer, it's really important for your doctor to catch that as early as possible. The scary thing about choroidal melanoma is that if it was to ever spread in your body or metastasize, it most likely goes to the liver. And when that happens, it has a very grim prognosis. In fact, the survival rate is only around 1% of people at 5 years after diagnosis. So again, it's super important that your eye doctor is able to detect these choroidal nevi and then monitor them for any sort of signs and symptoms that may hint toward melanoma development. Because if your doctor is able to catch it sooner, they can send you to an ocular oncologist, and hopefully with treatment, they can prevent it from spreading to other parts of the body. So now that we know the basics of what's going on here, let's talk about what your doctor is looking for inside the eye and a couple of the different tests that you may see in an eye clinic for your doctor to understand what's going on. I think it'll be kind of interesting for you to see what your doctor's looking for and how we think about it. First of all, your doctor is going to want to have a complete eye exam, and they're likely going to want to dilate your eye so they can see the best view personally of what's going on inside. Then your doctor is likely going to take at least a photograph of the back of the eye, because that's going to be the best way for not just your doctor, but maybe other doctors to subtly tell if there's been a change. And I personally recommend annual photographs of choroidal nevi, no matter how big or small they are, just again, because we can detect more subtle change that way. Now, guidelines in medicine are always changing and updating with new research and new technology, but here's just kind of a snapshot mnemonic that eye doctors, whether they're optometrists or ophthalmologists, use to monitor for choroidal nevi. Most eye doctors should know a mnemonic called "To find small ocular melanoma, use helpful hints daily." At the beginning of this mnemonic, we have two, and the capital T stands for thickness of the choroidal nevi, and anything greater than 2 millimeters is considered a risk factor. This is traditionally measured using ultrasound, but it can also be utilized, found with OCT technology, or optical coherence tomography, which is kind of a fancy way of doing ultrasound of the whole eye, except it's in much higher detail. It's kind of like getting a high-def ultrasound, which coincidentally, many eye clinics will use that same OCT technology to look for fluid, which stands for the F in the "to find." Any sort of presence of subretinal fluid on an OCT through the choroidal nevus is again a risk factor. Now the S on small, "to find small ocular melanoma," the S on small stands for symptoms. Now, symptoms for ocular melanoma, they are reported in studies to be like vision loss, typically people with worse than 20/50 vision. It also includes having flashes and floaters. However, about 90% of people who have these have no symptoms at all. So that's important for, I think, everyone to kind of think about. That you can have these things growing in the back of the eye and you may have no symptoms in your vision at all. So if you know somebody who's like, no, I never need to see the eye doctor, I see just fine. Well, they may in fact have something growing in the back there. So again, yeah, important to have your eyes checked. Then the O on ocular in the mnemonic stands for orange pigment, which your eye doctor may order a test called fundus autofluorescence, which is kind of a cool, almost nighttime photo of the back of the eye in a way, which shows metabolic activity. And your doctor may see this pigment basically growing on top of the nevus. And again, that's not good. And the M on melanoma in the mnemonic stands for margins of a choroidal nevus greater than or equal to 3 millimeters from the optic nerve head or the disc. And this is usually measured with fundus imagery, but the closer the choroidal nevus is to the optic nerve, again, the more likely it is to be a melanoma and possibly spread. Now U and H for use helpful hints daily. The UH is for ultrasound hollowness. So we'll do an ultrasound and we'll see that it's hollow. The next H is for halo absence, because a lot of these choroidal nevi will have kind of a halo of depigmentation around them. And if it's gone, again, higher risk. And then D for daily is drusen absence. Drusen is a type of protein that usually forms on the top of long-standing choroidal nevi. And so again, if you don't see drusen, then it may be a newer formation. And now there's a newer mnemonic that's still largely the same thing. It's still to find small ocular melanoma, but instead of the use helpful hints daily, we now use DIMS, which could stand for either doing imaging or that you're looking for a diameter greater than 5 millimeters on fundus photography. And really just highlights the importance of doing all these different imaging techniques, whether you're doing ultrasound, OCT, fundus autofluorescence, or at least taking some form of a photograph of the back of the eye. Now, with all of these pieces in mind, your doctor can then calculate the risk factor of it becoming a melanoma. And if you're somebody who just has a nevus but has no risk factors, you have about a 1% risk of that being a melanoma. But as soon as you have at least one risk factor, you have an 11% risk. If you have two risk factors, it goes up to 22%. Three, it's about 34%. And as soon as you have four or more of those risk factors, you have a greater than 50% chance that that nevus is in fact a melanoma. And again, if this was detected, your doctor is going to refer you to see an ocular oncologist, where they're likely going to treat with either radiation or, unfortunately, surgery. And that means that they're either going to treat it, resulting in vision loss or potentially blindness, and then perhaps just complete removal of the eyeball. Again, because they want to treat it before it spreads to any other part of the body. Thankfully, for most people who have these choroidal nevi or these freckles on the back of the eye, they never convert to a melanoma. But considering the hazard ratio and just the risk of what it means to potentially vision loss and even mortality, it's super important, again, that your doctor is able to catch these and monitor them closely. And I think the biggest lesson for us all to learn is that whether you think your eyesight is great or not, it's super important to have your eyes checked on a regular basis. In fact, you'd be surprised at how many case reports are always that somebody got hit in the eye or something else happened to their eye and they went in to see their eye doctor and it just happened to be by chance your doctor noticed that there's this large thing growing back there. So remember that you only have two eyes, so please take care of them. So hey, thanks for watching our video today. If you enjoyed this video or you learned something new, please smash the like button, drop a comment below, or subscribe to the channel if you are new. Making these videos are always a lot of fun for me, but it does take a lot of work and dedication to keep making them. So all the support you can give us, I greatly appreciate it. Otherwise, again, thanks for watching. This is Dr. Alan here. Keep an eye on it, and we'll talk to you soon.